Huawei App Gallery have a fantastic offer. Running from now up until the 30th of September, every euro you spend in-game will convert to a diamond. You can then take your diamonds and redeem awesome vouchers in the game to enable you to make more pack purchases. On top of this, we have the loyalty coupons and VIP rewards to make your money go even further. Now, you do need to make sure your app region is on Italy or Netherlands to take advantage of this, and all of the links are in the description below, guys. If you're not using this, you're doing it wrong. Save money with Huawei App Gallery. What's going on, guys? It's your boy Worthy Prince coming at ya with another Lords mobile video. And today, guys, I'm gonna be talking to you about an issue we had recently in TWK. These aren't my favorite videos to make, but at the end of the day, I feel like I want to share this with you guys because I'm pretty sure there's plenty guilds out there that have had this issue, and it's something that really drives leadership teams insane in guilds. Is when you've got a rat in your guild. Now, some people like to call them spies. Personally, I like to call them rats. And yeah, I mean, it's just not a very nice thing to have in your guild, especially if the whole guild are aware of it. It lowers morale. It just has a real downwards effect on a guild. I've seen it really do some serious damage to guilds. The worst thing about having a rat in your guild is this person will blend in very, very well. Like a chameleon. They will pretend to be your friend. They'll want to help out. You would never ever suspect them to be doing anything bad towards you or the other people in your guild at all. But the truth of the matter is, in the shadows, they are doing everything they can to undermine your every move, making you fail as much as they possibly can. They're not very nice people, guys. They're what I like to also call pond scum. Absolute nasty, nasty people. And you know what? It happens. I would love to use some stronger words. I'm not gonna, but they are absolutely horrible. So look, end of the day, what we're getting at here is that TWK had a real nasty rat in our guild for the last couple of months. Now, before I get into some clips, I just want to give you a little bit of context, okay? This person was in our guild in the previous Baron, not the one we just done, the previous TWK Baron, and they were speeding the timer continuously. Now, I didn't turn up to this Baron because I had to go and do some things in my personal life, but Bear and one of my other leads that we had at the time, Stubby, went to the Baron with the guild to do, you know, some rallies, get some kills. They had to literally cancel the Baron halfway through, or not even halfway through, and port back to Home Kingdom because every single rally was being sped up on the timer. Now, when I went to this Baron the weekend just gone, you never saw it in the Baron video I posted yesterday, but we had the same issue there. I noticed that my timer at the beginning of the Baron was being sped up. And even though we were saying in the chat, yo, come on, stop it. Some of my R4s were trying to be more diplomatic and saying, yo, guys, understand, you don't need to speed the timer during a rally. I knew full well this wasn't something being done by accident. This was intentional and doing it on purpose to completely mess up our rallies. Now, as we go through this, I'm going to be coming back at you with some more commentary because some things happened during this Baron, which were quite interesting regarding this issue. And then the final stage when I actually revealed to the whole guild who the spy was and removed them from the guild and how that came about. So sit back, guys, open up yourself a fresh box of cookies and a nice glass of warm milk because we all love a little bit of drama, don't we, from time to time. So let's get into the clips. TWK's ready with 208.
Is Alan with us or not with us? I'm sorry.
Alan is with you.
Oh, why am I walking? There was no
time. LG go. LG has go.
You want me to pull?
I'm canceling. It's fine. I'm going
to
reset.
LM, be ready to pull.
I'm ready to pull.
Олег, ты готов? Выходи.
Я готов.
Выходи, 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 сразу выходи уже.
Does she be ready in a minute?
LM pull. LM pull.
Hold. Hold.
Okay. RG, please walk slow. RG, please walk slow.
Okay, you are okay.
Who is ready else?
TV.
SWA is ready in
30
seconds.
SWA go. LM next. Go. SWA go carpet.
They're ready in 30 seconds.
So LM going carpet. LM going carpet.
LM going.
Hit it with cab front. It's all inf.
Send black wing.
Okay, nice.
We need Pyris on Hachi 343-643. Please. Pyris 343-643.
His ward is up.
Hurry up.
LM is ready to pull. Just let me know when.
SWA is ready to.
Yeah, don't need to take kids if you are not full, but I think your guys can feel you because no rallies.
Yep. 55 seconds for LG.
RPS, what is your timer?
220.
Pull.
Too late.
Do you want SWA to go?
SWA go.
Go.
SWA go.
SWA
go. Carpet.
Carpet SWA.
I'm really sorry, guys. I've got a
SGB.
I've got a spy.
8 seconds.
SWA. Next time, don't pull because too much solo.
You need to pick.
SGB is walking.
SGB carpet. SGB carpet.
AMD ready.
Try to take reinforces.
Guys, I've got a spy in my field that's speeding
walking
the
timer. Walk slow.
He's walking.
EMD. Hey, no, can EMD carpet. EMD go. EMD go in carpet. Carpet.
TV ready.
Nice. Hold a little, please. If you see coalition speed, it cancel. Who is ready, please? Tell again.
TV.
Walk slow, please.
Mike, just start kicking any small player it's not feeling that you don't know until it stops.
Sorry, the last three rallies I've set, as soon as they get down to 10 seconds, they speed my timer in, and I've already said it three times in the chat, and they keep doing it every rally. Like, the last rally,
DV carpet, please.
They just keep speeding it in.
DV carpet, please. DV carpet.
Just kick people till it stops.
Mike, kick right, Super man. Hawk again. It happened again. He's okay. In.
All right, then give me 2 seconds.
No.
I'm going to have to kick a couple of people from the guild. Just...
Hey, you're fine. Just handle it.
DV, don't pull next time. Guys, who is ready?
All right,
RPS is ready, guys.
20 seconds. SWA going carpet.
SWA going. Shit, I hit the wrong button. Sorry. SWA carpet.
And try to hold the little.
Okay, so you've seen the timer get sped in twice now already. I've got a couple more clips to show you from this Baron, okay, of it happening. But I'm pretty sure you guys can already tell I'm starting to get agitated by it. Bear is as well, because of course Bear went for it on the previous Baron. And so yeah, it's starting to get to me a bit. Obviously, when I'm doing a Baron, I'm not just doing my rally, I'm also recording what's going on the Baron base with the rest of the guilds, like, so I can make the video for you guys, so I can show you the action that's happening. But for the first 30 minutes of the Baron, I wasn't able to do that. I was constantly looking inside my rally screen, not the Baron base. I was missing a lot of the good action that happened in the first 30 minutes of Baron because of this problem. But let's get into the next couple of clips and you'll see as it progresses.
You want me to hold?
Hold.
Tell me when a rally's coming. I'm on withdrawal screen.
Don't take hits. Don't take hits. You don't need blackings. Why are you fooled? No rally, okay, guys. Who is ready?
TV ready.
I need more go. Pirates to 322656. Pirates 322656.
Opa. MD go in carpet. RPS, box low. MD carpet. Nice hit. MD pull. RPS carpet. MD pull. RPS carpet.
I'm ready in 5 seconds.
Who are you?
TWK, ready in 5 seconds. My timer has been sped again.
TWK.
I'm walking slowly. I've got a minute walk time. I'll walk at a minute and cancel.
Okay, nice. RPS ready, yeah?
The thing with RPS, you can walk in. Not? Yes, they're ready.
RPS ready.
Okay, now when one timer just doesn't do the job, maybe we can do it with two timers. Maybe having two timers will confuse the rat. Let's see.
RG, are you ready?
Get JL fed out there.
Yes, are you ready? Want us to go?
Yes, go, go, go.
Okay,
TV
go
ready.
Carpeting? Carpet, please?
Yes. Go on carpet.
30 Thank seconds you. For me.
RG's in.
Yep.
So when
minute
people?
40 for SGB.
No. Wait.
I know that OP is not ready. OP is not ready this time for me if I go.
As you can see, two timers. They sped both of them.
The time. 15 seconds for me.
I'm ready to walk. My timer's been sped again. I'm ready to walk.
9, 8.
You speeding your timer?
I'm walking.
SV.
All right, we'll walk.
RG, please pull.
Okay, so as you've seen so far in this video, look, it was causing some big issues for us in Baron. Okay, now something that changed the dynamic of what was going on is what Bear did. Bear actually went and spoke to IGG on customer support to try and see if they could tell us who was actually doing it. Now, IGG record everything you do with your account, every message you send, everything you click on. There's a log to show that you've actually done something in the game. So IGG should be able to tell us exactly what player has been speeding that particular timer during that first part of the Baron. So Bear's on with IGG customer support. I put a comment in the chat as well to say, hey, Bear, that's great news. We can find out who's actually doing this and remove them. And I'd already mentioned previously that we're going to put 15 rallies on this person the moment we find out who they are. The next thing that happened was quite interesting because one of the players that was at the Baron decided to migrate out of the Baron. And not only did they migrate out of the Baron, they didn't go back to K75 where the Baron team was and where we were planning to go back to straight away after, of course. They actually migrated back to Kingdom 174, which we found really, really odd. And the funny thing is, the player that did that was also under suspicion a few couple of months back. Some of you people might remember from the stream that we was doing WoW. Someone in our guild was giving away troop comps using an alt of they had an alt account inside TWK. And, you know, the other guild spoke to us and said, hey, I think it was Quackers that reached out to me and said, you know, there's someone in your guild giving us troop comps. This is the person's name. He sent me pictures online. I went into my member list to go and find it. I found the name of it. And just as I was about to kick it, it left the guild. But the nickname was the same name as the person that was acting really suspicious during this Baron. So there was already a red flag on that person, but I gave them the benefit of the doubt. Now the same person pulls out of the Baron the moment we say we're about to find out who it is. To me, that was them playing safe. Now, for the rest of the Baron, I had absolutely no more issues. No more speeding of timers, no issues for the remaining 3 hours of Baron. And you can see how much fun we had from the video we posted yesterday. If you haven't seen the Baron video, check it out. It's up on the channel right now. So the next question is, what happened next? So now it comes down to IGG coming in clutch and telling us exactly who it is so we can deal with it. we had to wait 24 hours for the result from IGG because they wanted to do the usual, give us your email, we'll look into it, and we'll get back to you. Okay, no problem at all. 24 hours went past. Finally, Bear got his reply. And here is the answer we got from IGG. So as you can see, IGG were no help at all. However, I didn't want the guild to know this. So me and Bear decided to play a bluff. I wrote this guild mail. Hey peeps. So as you know, someone was speeding our timer during Baron on purpose. This is the second Baron this has happened. IGG responded this morning from Bear's complaint and they have confirmed the name of the account which has been doing this. We would like to avoid embarrassing this person publicly and are therefore giving this person 24 hours time frame from this mail to leave quietly of their own accord. If this person does not remove themselves, I will not only make this public within TWK, which I have done, but I will also make it publicly humiliate them to thousands on my channel, which I'm doing right now. The choice is yours. Take this seriously because I know who you are. And honestly, I'm very surprised. Bit shocked, to be honest, but mostly disappointed. Unfortunately for me, this mail didn't work. This spy has been, this rat, this stinking hairy rat has been rooted in our guild for a good 2 months now, and they weren't prepared to give up their spot in our guild as the dirty rat off the back of this mail. So they decided to call my bluff, even though the rat already had a couple of red flags on his head and we were watching closely. They decided to, you know, call my bluff. Well, it backfired big time on them because the next thing that happened gave me the third red flag and I knew 100% it was them. Now I'm going to show you the clip that confirmed it for me and I'm going to put some context into it now before you see the clip, okay? After Baron finished, we had a rally party, which the video is coming very soon. We had a rally party in Kingdom 75. Now, the person that migrated back to 174 decided during the rally party to migrate back to Kingdom 75. Why? To join the rally party? No, of course not. They came back to Kingdom 75 because they knew they wouldn't be able to speed a timer from Kingdom 174. Now, for the first 2 hours of the rally party, there was no need for timers, so we didn't notice anything. But then eventually, I had to put a rally on a timer, and the first timed rally that came up with a timer, they struck again. And you are going to see the rat in action, not joining the rally, but instead porting to the target and continuing to scout and one troop the target to make it look like it's not them. They came to try and do some kind of prove my innocence here by saying, you know, oh, it can't be them. They're at the target one trooping. You're going to see them pause their one troops and pause their scouts. And the moment they pause, that's when you're going to see the timer speed up. You ready for the clip? Roll it.
Oh my God.
There we go. Cracker, are you counting down for the release timer?
Yeah, I will. Once we get close. Everybody should be on timer, correct?
We have 30 seconds for you ready to walk.
Yeah, same for us.
Your THS is up really late.
Okay, but I need to know how long before you're walking, Gus.
156.
Okay, everybody sit on timers for at least 2 minutes. Sit on timers for at least 2 minutes.
Don't touch that timer, Bear. I'll do it.
I know, I sent it in as a timer on purpose.
Thank you, buddy. I'll do that now. Thank you.
Everybody should be sitting on timers. Do not walk. Oh, somebody hit.
Doesn't show anything hitting my mic.
Okay. Maybe I just didn't see the last two rallies.
No, yeah, I didn't either earlier.
Everybody should be sitting on their timers.
THS is right next to the target, so we're going to walk through.
someone speeding our timer up. Yeah, our timer just got sped by the troll. Yeah, the troll just done it. It's okay. He's still in our guild.
Alright.
Oh, my hell, trying to pop again.
What the fuck?
Really?
I just got... Oh, he counted me, though. So, there you have it. That was our spy, Mr. Kratos. Now, this was a real shock to me. He'd been in TWK for quite some time. And when he joined, he was super, super helpful. He has loads of alt accounts, which he brought in and done a bunch of Guildfest on for us. Like I said at the start of this video, guys, a rat will come into your guild and there will be the most helpful person. You will never, ever suspect them. But eventually they will slip up. And he made a couple of slips over the last couple of months, which have led us to know that it's him, okay? So, as you can see from this profile picture, he's changed his name by now. Of course, he's changed his name. But this is his gear, in case you get anyone that has got identical gear to this, with this amount of kills and this might. Just be careful. And here are his stats as well. So if you ever get someone applied to your guild that looks very similar to this, you can always come back and cross-check it. Here is the stats that he has on his account as well. So I went ahead during that rally party and I kicked him from the guild. Anyone that was innocent, anyone that, you know, I'd made a mistake on would have been straight into my inbox or straight into lineup saying, hey, what's going on? You know, but oh my God, I didn't do nothing wrong. Because during Baron, I removed a couple of people to try and work out how it was. And immediately those two people were in our inboxes, mine and Bear's, saying, yo, we've done nothing wrong. What's going on? Don't kick us. He didn't say a word. And you know why? Because he probably thought that the what I said about IGG coming through on that guild mail probably was true. And I knew it was him. So he probably thought there's no point in me trying to say anything otherwise because he knows it's me. And he said nothing. He just left the chat after being with us for quite a while, being our friend, chatting with us in guild chat, making us believe he was one of us. Just leaves the guild without saying a word. So all that's left to say is I hope that we never see Kratos darken our doorstep at TWK or any of your guilds in the future. Kratos, you've been confirmed as a complete rat. My advice to you, my friend, would be to take your account and all of your alt accounts and insert them into your asshole. That's what I would do. Other than that, there you go, guys. I'm sure you enjoyed a little bit of drama. I bet all your cookies are gone and your milk's evaporated. But that's going to be the end of the video for today. I'll catch you later for Dragon Arena. But until then, you know how this next bit's going to go. Stay safe, everyone. And of course, peace out.